Yeah, the other movies that I've done, it has very much been in somebody's basement or somebody's studio. But this is the first time, like, seeing what we've been working on for months and tinkering to a point of satisfaction, and then seeing it all play with, what is it, like 50?
Yeah, I think we've got 50, 55 today.
55.
Yeah. Not including brass.
Not including brass. Which is overwhelming, but it's really nice to see. I've only seen it on, like, making of videos.
Yeah, now. Same.
But being part of something like this is just like, oh, wait. When I thought I was being surprised enough with the whole process, this is like another level.
Yeah, it's like it's a whole extra dimension that it, mm-hmm. you know, and from us sitting in my studio and listening to the demos, and you know, you get the demos to a point where you're like, oh, this sounds huge, and then you hear it here and it's like, well, yeah, we'll just delete the demo.
Definitely is like times 10.
You know, and it's really, really humbling and amazing just to see these musicians take things, you know, that have come from my studio in my house, and you know, that we've been looking at on this little screen, to all these guys just opening the page and playing it, is such a beautiful experience. Yeah, I mean there's a lot of stuff, you know, that there's very kind, you know, some of it's kind of almost like techno, you know, like there's a little like pulling from like a lot of like modern kind of, you know, dance music and electronic music kind of production techniques, and then, you know, there's very traditional orchestra stuff on top, but with the even with where we're going quite traditional with the orchestra, I try and throw something in, you know, to detune everything or to have it in different registers that you don't normally get these kind of scores. And you know, then there's this whole kind of like, you know, like kind of vaporwave-esque kind of like, you know, big glassy synths, and you know, there's a ton of modular synths and custom things that I've made. And then on top of that, like, you've got these kind of chugging like 7-string guitars, and it's almost like nu metal-esque. Like, you know, when you strip it back, like some of it, it's like, you know, we talked about like, you know, demon Jimmy Page.
Yeah, like, you know, like channeling your Jimmy Page energy.
Yeah, exciting for you to listen to it. Like, what was the most exciting playback that we had?
I mean, there's like every moment has its own thing, yeah. I guess, in the movie.
There's like micro themes.
There's micro themes throughout. I think like ultimately there's like the one that we started off. Like, I think it was like the first one we started off and like really understanding what we're going for was on the cosmic realm energy. Yeah. You know, how can we make it unique, but at the same time feel like it's familiar, but it's familiar because it's making you feel something.
Yeah, like nostalgia plays a big part in it, I think.
There's a lot of nostalgia there. But I think like the one that when I heard it the first time, like blew my mind was on the third act.
I think that, I mean, for me, like I don't like talking about music technically because it doesn't mean anything, you know, like all that means anything is if you feel it, you know, like you can look at me and say the scene's not working and I can try and technically explain to you what I've done, but if it's not hitting you there, then it doesn't matter.